the bottom half of the ninth inning. But some timely hitting got the bases loaded for a Clemson team that was trying to rally from a six-run deficit through seven innings. Tigers eventually push a run across against the bullpen of Georgia State. Cooper Engel, his fifth hit of the game, driving in another run. Engel with four batted in. Then with two men out, Billy Amick picking the right time to hit his first career home run. A walk-off grand slam. The stuff dreams are made of as Clemson rallies for the 9-8 triumph against Georgia State. From the thrills of Friday night to a beautiful Saturday afternoon here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium, the Tigers and Panthers of Georgia State will play too as Clemson goes for a series sweep against their opponent out of the Sun Belt Conference. Hi, everybody. Welcome in with Ron Smith, Pete Yannity. So the ninth inning's unfolding last night. Ron, you were here doing the game. I know you had a specific thought in mind as you saw that inning continue on.
Well, first, the critical two runs scored in the eighth thanks to Cannarella and Engel. And then I just thought that if Clemson had 7, 8, 9 coming up, if they could get to the top of the order in those hot batters, that they had a chance, and that's exactly what happened.
So Georgia State will try to bounce back. Their starting lineup, Cameron Jones, the right fielder, leads off. Max Ryerson, the DH, batting second. The shortstop, Ruiz, third. JoJo Jackson, followed by Will Mize and Dylan Strickland. Luke Boynton, 3-for-3 with a couple of home runs Friday night. He's at first. Then batting eighth, the catcher, Blaine Marchman, and Dalton Pearson, the center fielder, rounding out Brant Stromdahl's starting lineup. And the first pitch from Tristan Smith of the Tigers coming at 1:01 p.m. on a beautiful day, Ron, here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium. A little bit windy. Tristan Smith getting another start for the Tigers in his freshman season. What upside he has. His fifth appearance, his third start, and they really liked what he did the last time out and think he can build on it.
I agree. Upside, I think, is the critical word for him. He has a great potential and a great future in this program. You see that 91-mile-an-hour fastball, high three-quarter delivery. He's got an electric arm.
Ahead of the 294 hitter as this game begins, Jones. And the 0-2 pitch, Cooper Engel climbs the ladder to get it.
And Jones is a huge base-running threat. I mean, I think he's 14 of 16 on the bases, but he was not much of a factor yesterday. Didn't get on base.
Count evens 2-2. Smith, we told you the third career start. Seven innings pitched so far, 9 strikeouts for the former Boiling Springs Bulldog, who had things worked out differently on the MLB draft weekend. Might be in pro ball, but his head coach, Eric Backage, says he's in a good spot, and obviously they love to have him. 4 2/3, didn't get a decision Sunday against South Carolina. Gave up a couple of hits. No runs, 5 strikeouts, has yet to allow a run in his college career.
Pretty impressive, especially against the Gamecocks. Now, this is a Georgia State team that will battle at the plate. They don't strike a lot. They've really cut down on their strikeouts from last year. And this is a veteran club that makes a pitcher work.
Again, a 3-2 pitch. And the junior out of Kathleen, Georgia, fouling it off again. Guy was preseason all Sun Belt Conference. Good league. These guys are picked down in their conference, but Southern Miss, the favorite. You've got Coastal Carolina, some real good dudes. Georgia Southern in that conference.
Really, really strong baseball league.
And you see the battle continue.
Well, again, this is the MO for Georgia State. They just battle at the plate and make a pitcher really work.
Jones 0-for-4 last night. A year ago, when Georgia State came in here and won a midweek game, he also was 0-for-4 in that contest. Yeah.
Well, you know, and now you're looking at a 10-11 pitch at bat for the leadoff hitter. That is ideal if you're from the Georgia State standpoint.
The battle goes on. Tristan Smith, 6'2", 200 pounds. Just three walks so far in his seven innings of work and trying to avoid another one right here. Yet again, the payoff pitch. Off the plate, barely, and a leadoff walk for Cameron Jones. Jones on the season, you mentioned, Ron, good base runner. He's 14 of 16 for a team that's stolen 28 of 31, so they'll keep an eye on him.
Yeah, there are not holes in this lineup. Everybody is an offensive threat, and every one of their guys has stolen some bases. So be interesting to see what they do against the left-hander.
One of their best power threats, Max Ryerson. Four homers on the season. Two for four last night. He's cut down on the strikeouts this year. Hit 22 a year ago, but his head coach says way too many strikeouts. Yeah. And he kind of embodies what they've really emphasized this year, staying in the zone. And they've been much more efficient at the plate as a result.
Get base runners. You know, strikeouts just don't help you offensively at all, obviously.
Skied on the infield, foul territory. Last night's hero, Amick, battling. It'll drop foul. Don't know if that was necessarily wind-aided, but a free pass for Ryerson.
That one had trouble written over it, all over it from the very beginning. Really high pop-up, had some serious hang time. And the mistake that Amick made is he got directly under the ball. So you lose perspective. You've got to stay maybe 5 to 10 feet behind the ball so you can drive, can walk in on it and make the catch.
Scored an E3.
And you could call that a free pass, but that was
a dozen pitches.
Yeah,
and
both, you know, you just tip your hat to the hitter and to the pitcher because Tristan Smith was pounding the strike zone, and Jones able to just foul off four or five pitches, 12 pitch at bat. There he goes.
Runner on the move. Ingles throw, tag out. Just the third time in 17 attempts that Jones has been taken out of the base pass. And a base runner gunned down here in the first inning for Cooper Ingle.
Yeah, he really didn't get a great jump, but I'll tell you what, Cooper Ingle got rid of that one in a hurry and made an accurate throw. Good tag by Bertram.
And quickly two away for strikeout of the game registered by Smith.
Well, that changes the momentum of, it, of
boy,
an inning
oh
that being thrown out at second base on the stolen base attempt. You know, arm side run fastball at 91, 92. That was actually 93 miles an hour. And again, you're looking at the potential of this young freshman on the mound.
Ruiz, the shortstop, swings through a 92 mile an hour fastball. One for five with two batted in last night at his third homer of the season. First year in their program after transferring in from USF. Among their RBI leaders with 14 so far. Smith delivers the 1-1. Ingle tried to frame.
Well, he stayed pretty much fastball throughout this first inning on a couple of breaking balls. A lot of pitchers like to get through the first, through the order one time with nothing but fastballs. If they can, that's the ideal thing. And then that second time through, you can start mixing things up.
Playing two today with the bad weather forecast. They actually changed things up in their pitching rotation. They're kind of trying to piece it together. Tigers will go with Caden Grice on a pitch count in game number two.
And I think they're going to start stretching out Caden Grice. I mean, I think each outing they're going to try to get a little bit more from him in terms of his pitch count.
Again, a 2-2 pitch. Called strike three. Gets one swinging, gets one looking. Tristan Smith not impacted by the leadoff walk. Georgia State done in the top half of the first inning. The freshman for the Tigers delivering, and Clemson's coming up.
Hey, Seth. You getting ready to roll?
Yep, road trip. And now that I'm rolling with Verizon, I get why more people choose it.
Nice.
And I got this incredible iPhone 14 Pro on them.
Oh, love the camera. So you got an amazing network and save money doing it.
That's how I roll. Oh, no.
You like your keys in the car again?
Yeah, I did.
Switch now and get iPhone 14 Pro on us. There's more. You get Apple Watch SE and iPad, all three on us. That's a value of up to $1,700. But hurry, this offer won't last long. Get the savings you want on the network you deserve. Verizon.
To you, it may just be an elevator.
Here goes nothing.
But for a young homeowner becoming their parents, it's a learning opportunity.
Come on in. The more the merrier.
Paris, huh?
Bonjour.
We got any out-of-towners in the elevator?
Tom, it is not easy.
10th floor, huh? Must be a heck of a view.
Okay. See how everyone else is facing this way?
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home and auto with us.
Okay, that was terrible. Okay, let's hang back. We're going to try that again.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. You know it didn't come to play. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now's the time to get in and get away. Get 0% APR financing plus zero payments for 90 days on select Hyundai vehicles.
Cam Cannarella and Cooper Engle achieved something last night for the Tigers not done in over 40 years. Probably had Caden Grice in amazement with his Tiger teammates. They lead things off for Eric Backich. Will Taylor hits third, the DH, followed by the hero last night, Amick at first in the cleanup spot. Bertram, Hall, Abrams, Blackwell, and Starbuck. Rounding out the lineup for the Tigers, first-year head coach. First of two against the Panthers of Georgia State on this Saturday afternoon. Going to be a lefty, and like his counterpart, he wears the number 18. Does Cameron Landry? Landry will try to handle a Tiger lineup that got 17 hits against Georgia State pitching last night.
Yeah.
Guy who can touch 88 to 91. Pretty much a three-pitch mix, but the fastball and the curve are his friend.
Curveball's probably his best pitch, so he's going to have to throw that four strikes. But of those 16 or 17 hits last night, 13 of them came from the first three hitters in the order for the Tigers.
Top two batters in this Clemson lineup, each with five hits last night. Cannarella, 5-for-6. Cooper Engle, 5-for-6, as Cannarella, the freshman out of Hartsville, stands in and takes strike one. 1982, last time two batters in the game for Clemson, each with five hits. Guy you may have heard of, Jimmy Key, pretty good pitcher in the majors, but could also swing the bat in his college days. And Brooke Shoemake did it. Eric Backich, the Clemson head coach in 1982, was playing T-ball. He was 5 years old. Cannarella ahead in the count, 2-1. He has obviously settled one of the outfield slots. That was an area in question coming in. Still trying to figure things out around him in that Tiger outfield.
Oh, this young man is just, we've talked about his maturity level, his approach at the plate, and his
coming off the bat, but right at somebody.
Well, I think he raised his batting average 40 points yesterday. So, and that can happen this time of year, but you know he can swing the bat.
He's hitting eight straight, 13 of his last 31. Runner on the move, Cannarella got a great jump, and he beats the throw. Well, again, 8 of 9 now on stolen bases.
Again, this young man continues to impress, does what he needs to do in that leadoff position, takes pitches, and then to get on there and get a really good jump and just barely get in there safely at second base. That was close.
Man in scoring position for Engle. Tigers had some bumps in the road over the first few weeks of the season with runners in scoring position.
Well, and now, Pete, you know, for Coach Backage, he talks about team offense. And so the job of Cooper Engel is at least to advance Cannarelli to third base with one out. And then you've got to put the ball in play, and you're going to have a run.
And a good spray hitter at that. Count evens a 2-2 on the Tiger Jr. out of Asheville.
I think with less than two strikes, you really make an effort to hit the ball to the right side. Not with two strikes, you just, you know, you just want to put it in play. But, boy, if you can pull it, it's all the better. Good pitch.
Called strike three. Got him on the outside corner. 79 miles an hour, and it's one away.
Backdoor curveball. We talked about that being his top pitch, and that is a tough pitch. That's one of those that maybe you just fight off as a hitter and try to get to that next pitch.
Last time out last Saturday, 2 2/3 innings against Presbyterian. Took the loss, allowed five hits, two earned runs, four strikeouts, one walk. For Landry, the 6'3 junior, just outside of Atlanta in Johns Creek. Will Taylor's found a home at DH and in the three hole. 3 for 5 last night. A walk and a couple of strikeouts. Cannarella, big jump, got him leaning, throw back, and he just was able to get a hand on the base.
Aggressive base running, and this is something that Clemson has brought to the table this year that they've not had over the last couple of years. And he's trying to get to third base with one out.
1-1 the count on Taylor, the sophomore out of Irmo in the Midlands. Comes into the ball game 6 of his last 16. And now 1-2. Taylor, one area he's trying to improve. Strikeouts, 12 of them, including those two last night. And obviously with one man out and a man in scoring position, trying to put down a marker here early. Big pitch upcoming for Landry.
Well, when you swing at pitches that are outside of the strike zone, it makes it all the tougher.
Off-speed stays outside. Count evens a 2-2. Yeah, we've talked about it before, Ron. We've done some games. He didn't return to action from a knee injury in the fall of 21 until May of last year, did Will Taylor. And all still part of a process of coming all the way back. We're about a year and a half out from that happening to him in October 21 in the football game against Boston College. But a potential first-round draft pick, or at least first two-round draft pick when he was coming out of Dutch Fork, you just see the ability, and you think the speed is going to get even, you know, further back to what it was.
Well, I think the more at-bats he gets this year, the better he's going to be. Obviously, he has great hands.
Stays high, and the count goes full.
And had great speed. I'm not sure he's running quite as well after the knee surgery. But really remarkable that he was able to come back so quickly after having the surgery and in the fall and actually play some baseball into spring. There's a curveball that's up.
First and second now with two away. Second walk in the inning by Landry. Tigers have something going here in the home first after working around a leadoff walk and an error in the top half.
Billy. Amick given a nice round of applause by the Clemson faithful. Well deserved. Interesting, though, that they booed him when he didn't catch that foul ball. No, they didn't.
Yeah, no, they were gracious as well. They should be, as he takes high and tight. And
yeah, we'll give you a break on that.
Yeah. And Landry probably wanted to send a message there. I'm not giving you a 1-0 slider.
Right.
Mr. Hero, but, boy, unbelievable moment. First career home run, a walk-off grand slam with two outs and your team down by three in the bottom of the ninth. And he skies that on the right side. Boynton, the first baseman. Let's see if he has room. And one first baseman retires the other for out number two.
high fastball, and Amy just couldn't quite get there.
Riley Bertram, 1-for-4 last night. The Michigan transfer come an anchor in that infield at second base.
Between he and Blackwell, you've got great experience and really solid infield play so far this season for the Tigers. Tigers left 16 on yesterday.
Yeah, just coming through with guys in scoring position. And, you know, when a team struggles out of the gate, obviously, yeah, they'd like to be better than the 8-6 record at this point. That's usually an area either you look at pitching and right, walks and that kind of thing, batting average against, but you also look at how efficient they've been at the plate. Off speed in a butte, 78 miles an hour, and the count evens at 1-1 on the Zionsville, Indiana native.
Timely hitting, two out RBIs are huge. There's an opportunity for Bertram right here.
First and second, Canarello, the runner at second base. And right behind him, Taylor at first. 2-1 the count on Bertram. Nathan Hall would be next.
Now Bertram hitting just 213, but he does have 8 RBI.
Count evens a 2-2. Tristan Smith, couple of strikeouts with a man on. Well, after a man was on, and they cut down the runner. Jones trying to steal second base in the top half of this inning. And Landry one strike away from getting out of a first and second situation in the bottom half. The count goes full.
Get the runners, boy, you know, anything hit in the gap, now you've got an opportunity to score two with both runners getting started here.
Bertram, a 213 hitter. Three of his last 14, center field on the move. Jackson, or rather Pearson, and that'll do it for the Tigers in the first. They leave two scoreless after one.
I was having challenges with my old bank. Lots of red flags. Yellow ones too. Fees, penalties,
unnecessary fees,
playing dirty. So I broke up with bad banking and moved on with SoFi Checking and Savings. Now I earn higher interest on all my money and pay no account fees. Feels good to get my money right.
Banker disqualified.
Break up with bad banking. Get up to 3.75% interest and earn up to $250 when you set up direct deposit. SoFi, get your money right.
The 3 for Me only at Chili's serves up bottomless drinks, bottomless chips and salsa, and a classic old-timer with cheese and fries for just $10.99. Hey, it's 3 for Me, not 3 for us. It's my $10.99, it's my 3 for Me. Hey, get out of here. Nope. Ooh, I can whack hands all day. This Chili's 3 for Me is the best $10.99 you can eat.
Don't worry. It happens to the best of us.
It does?
It happens to surgeons, judges.
Overruled.
Airport ground crew, game show contestants.
Bermuda Triangle.
Megan Trainor. Bowlers. It even happened to your little cousin Timmy.
That doesn't even make sense.
That doesn't matter.
Thanks, Grandpa.
Brad Stromdahl trying to build the kind of program at Georgia State that he did when he started the Georgia Gwinnett team several years back. He had been a Georgia State assistant before heading elsewhere in the Atlanta area. Did a fine job with that program. Now he is year number 4, but really you take out the COVID year.
Right.
So he looks at it as year 3, and he thinks that he's probably one more recruiting class away from getting this program to where he wants to, where they can be a Sun Belt contender. He's real big on the template of recruiting big physical guys.
Well, they have that. They've done that, Pete. And you're right. I think he is happy. And I love the way he handled last night's loss. You know, he just kind of took it in stride. And, okay, we competed and you know, got beat late in the game. But it was not, you know, adversely affected at all.
Abrams in right, and Jackson, the left fielder, retired for out number one against Tristan Smith. Might be a high sun out there based on the reaction from Abrams.
Well, yeah, and guys seem to be having a little bit of problem. You've got a slightly overcast sky, but there is sun. There's a thin layer of clouds, and it's kind of hard to pick up the baseball.
Will Mize, 349 hitter, didn't mean to, but yes, he went, says the first base umpire Steve Sanders.
I'm not even sure why he checked on that one. Pretty obvious. Well, that I'm sorry, but this Tristan Smith's got a nice fastball.
It's just absolutely special.
Yeah, it's easy, really smooth delivery, effortless.
One of those induced vertical break guys Eric Backage will talk to you about. Makes quick work of the third baseman, Mize.
You see that fastball that he climbs the ladder up in the strike zone, and really tough to catch up to that pitch.
Three strikeouts so far for the lefty out of Boiling Springs. Had a great high school career for the Bulldogs in Spartanburg County. And delivers ball one to the second baseman, Dylan Strickland.
Well, Strickland started the scoring barrage yesterday with a massive home run to left field.
Fourth of the year for the junior out of Loganville, Georgia. Came to them from Georgia Tech. Second season playing for the Panthers. Man, the 2-0. Delivers a fastball. Catches the lower part of the zone. 2-1.
I'll tell you what, they'd really like to see him get out of here with a quick inning, few pitches, because he threw about 30 pitches in that first inning. Not his fault. I mean, Georgia State just fought off pitch after pitch after pitch. And so all of a sudden, he's up to pitch, 36? And it's only the second inning.
And an at-bat extended on an error in the first inning. Skied on the left side. Blackwell calling for it. And as desired, a reasonably quick second inning for Tristan Smith. Panthers go in order. Middle of two here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium.
Next on Behind the Series.
And on my years of playing, man, that 22 draft was something special.
If I hadn't seen it in person, I wouldn't have believed it.
Where can I even start?
The monster. It was scary good.
The outlaw? Come on.
The Philly had beef with everyone. And by beef, I mean tender, juicy steak.
It wasn't just a roster, it was a menu.
The Subway Series, the greatest menu of all time.
I'm getting hungry just to... Hey, can we take a... Hey, can I get a sandwich?
You'd do anything to give her everything. We'll help guide you every step of the way.
Hey, Seth, you getting ready to roll?
Yep, road trip. Now that I'm rolling with Verizon, I get why more people choose it.
Nice.
And I got this incredible iPhone 14 Pro on them.
Oh, love the camera. So you got an amazing network and save money doing it.
That's how I roll. Oh, no.
You like your keys in the car again?
Yeah, I did.
Switch now and get iPhone 14 Pro on us. There's more. You get Apple Watch SE and iPad, all three on us. That's a value of up to $7 you deserve. Verizon. Offer won't last long. Get the savings you want on the network you deserve. Verizon.
To shave or not to shave.
Shave. It's true.
To shave or not.
To shave or not to shave.
Shave. It's true.
To shave or not to shave. That.
Tigers head coach Eric Backage, you notice the mustache on him and all the guys, the staff, the players, on a team that has a no facial hair rule, but during the month of March, it's, well, something they're doing called Mustache March. They've teamed up with East Carolina, his alma mater, in the fight against ALS. It's to raise awareness in that. It's all in honor of a great man who was lost way too young, Keith LeClaire,
no
his
doubt.
Coach, who had a fine coaching career, was also connected to Jack Leggett. And
well, he was at Western and then went to Eastern Carolina and coached against him for a number of years, and really one of the best young baseball coaches you know you're ever going to come across. And this is kind of one of the many things that Coach Bakich is doing off the field with the players, trying to serve, get his players to be of service to others, and it's pretty impressive.
Nathan Hall, the leadoff single here in the Tigers' second inning. So the freshman now 6-for-20 in his Tigers' career, and he stands at first. Well, so that's why you see the mustaches on all the guys. Yeah. Mustache March. Go to the Clemson website. There's much more information on that, on how you can take part and support the cause. But they're trying to raise awareness and doing so in the memory of the late Keith LeClair.
Well, you know, Hall last night led the ninth off with a base hit, and that was just really big base hit for him.
0-1 on Gavin Abrams. Landry worked out of a first and second situation with just one away in the bottom half of the first inning.
Just out in front of that one a little bit.
Abrams, sophomore, 6-for-18 so far in the season. And strike one delivered. Sophomore out of St. John's, Florida, not far from Jacksonville. Getting an opportunity today in right field. Played in just two games a year ago, 333 in those two contests, with a couple batted in.
Well, he has swung the bat well in batting practice and preseason, so getting that opportunity. It goes fishing on that high fastball.
Second strikeout so far for Landry.
That might have been in the strike zone, but it was located well. Kind of tied him up a little bit, Pete. Hard to get your bat head to that fastball that's up and in.
Been a scuffle of late for Benjamin Blackwell, one for his last 16, 0-for-4 last night. Still his batting average at 283. Second-year Tiger shortstop as they chase Hall back to first.
Yeah, he is. Really dropped in the batting order. Just, you know the guy's going to hit. Just want to take a little pressure off of him.
Hall on the move. Throw down. Tag. And the ball gets loose. Now 2-of-2 on the season, stolen base-wise, for Nathan Hall, and a man in scoring position here in the second inning with less than two men out.
And that was actually a hit-and-run situation. You see Hall glance over his left shoulder, and he's out if they can catch the ball. But, and you saw the swing. Unable to make contact. It was a tough pitch to handle on a hit-and-run situation, but able to get the stolen base. Partly because Cameron Landry is not real quick to the plate. He's about 1-4.
Blackwell third in the Tigers with 10 batted in. Takes strike two, so he's in a hole. Ninth place hit in the order, Max Starbuck. Waits on deck behind Blackwell. Hall, big jump. Blackwell stays alive.
Again, there's that pitch that's in the upper part of the strike zone. Really hard to get your bat head on top of that. There you see Blackwell choking up on that bat a little bit, trying to put things in play.
Blackwell from just outside of Washington, D.C. Did he go? No. And the count goes 1-2. Good job by Marchman, the catcher, to not let the runner from second advance.
Especially that was bounced well out in front of him, and he just gave up his body and smothered it, controlled it out in front. No chance for Hall to advance. Tigers struck out 16 times last night. You don't win many games when you strike out 16 times.
Blackwell stays alive here. 9-17-2 for the Tigers last night. 8-10-2 for Georgia State. As Ron just noted, 16 strikeouts for Clemson. Panthers went down 9 times. And again, talk about more when they're coming up, but that's been an improving number that they've reduced this year, their strikeout totals. Get a 1-2 pitch to the Tigers shortstop. Count evens. He's one for his last 16. Blake Wright still out with illness. The third baseman who got off to such a great start. He's one for his last 16. A lot of guys scuffling. We're still very early in the season in this marathon. But at some point, Ron, I know you had to coach guys over the years. And then as a player yourself, you're going to go through it. I don't know really what you say to a guy when he's struggling like that as Blackwell fouls it away again.
Stay with it. Keep it simple. You know, one at bat does not a game or a season makes. You know, look at, see what happens many times when you scuffle like that, you hit the ball hard right at people. And so you have to look at how you hit the ball, not whether you got hits or not.
Big lead, throw behind the runner Hall. Nowhere close.
Yeah, Hall looking to go, and he had that.
Hall reaching on a stolen base and getting the second. Tag of Blackwell for out number 2 and a second strikeout in the inning.
Boy, Blackwell completely fooled on that breaking ball.
That has become a really good pitch for Landry.
Well, that is his best pitch. His curveball is his best pitch, and he often pitches off of that. Many pitchers pitch off of their fastball, but you'll see Landry start guys off with that breaking ball. And I love that, doing that, Pete, because most of the time on an 0-0 count, you throw a breaking ball, the guy's going to take it. If you throw it for a strike, it's, you know, you're up 0-1.
The old 12-6 curveball is what he throws, does Landry. Max Starbuck looking for his first hit on the season just 6 at-bats prior.
Well, they'd sure like to get a little production out of him today.
Got the start last night, 0 for 4. Again, Blake Wright, the regular third baseman, out with an illness. Skied to center, Pearson, as was the case in the bottom of the first, able to catch it for the final out here in the Tigers' second. Clemson strands a man at second base. Scoreless, we head to the third.
Watch this. When you watch me play, you support all of us.
You show your daughter, her future matters.
Take the shot. Drive, team up, win. When you watch me play, you prove we deserve more media coverage. When you watch the game, you change the game.
Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price when you sign up for multiple lines.
What? Multiple lines?
Hello? Yeah, one sec. But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
Just one line with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you need.
No, you hang up.
Are you even listening, guy who never looks up from his...
Get one line for $29.99, plus every plan is price protected. U.S. Cellular, built for us. $9.99, plus every plan is price protected. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
All right, Gunner, show me what you came up with. Doggone great clearance? No, seen that one. Pawsome sales event? Wow, really? Bonedacious deals? Oh. How do you feel about the Jeep celebration event?
Because right now you can get up to $9,000 off new 2022 Jeep Compass and as low as 1.9% on select new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram models. Find that and more at Big O under that big American flag on the Motor Mile.
Save a bundle? Now you're just hungry.
Ron, the ball was flying last night, and it's a pretty good hitter's ballpark. 4 home runs for Georgia State, 2 for the Tigers. Of course, the biggest blast of the night off the bat of Billy Amick, but the guy standing in, Luke Boynton, had himself quite a game. Couple of home runs on a 3-for-3 night, and he takes ball 1.
And he is a big physical guy, 250 pounds, and that first one that he hit...
As Abrams moves over to his right, and that's out number 1.
The first one that he hit had an exit velocity of 114. His launch angle was 20 degrees. Had he got it up to 25 or 30, it may have hit the softball field. It got out of here in a hurry.
Tristan Smith, third career start. Blake Marchman, the catcher. Kyle Hilton and Colin Hynek were behind the plate in the ball game last night for the Panthers, so they show their depth here.
They have some depth behind the plate.
Pitch from Smith. So probably taking all the way, Marchman, just his fifth game played this year. He's 4 for 10. And a 4-pitch walk.
Jeez. Well,
second free pass issued by Smith. One out base runner here in the third for the Panthers.
I mean, you often see a little more generous strike zone when it's 3-0. Not in this particular case. Veteran umpire John Mary behind the plate.
Ninth place hitter in the order, the center fielder, Dalton Pearson.
That's five balls in a row. Wouldn't be surprised. Yep.
Going to get a visit.
Jimmy Bellinger going to come out and just, you know, get a deep breath. And, you know, it's one of those things that you'd like to see Cooper do after you throw four or five pitches in a row, walk a guy, and then it's ball one. Get out there and let him regroup when he's pitching well. Got good stuff. May have just lost focus a little bit.
Smith, the number 6 freshman in the nation preseason by Perfect Game as a high schooler at Boiling Springs, number 24 player, and the number 6 left-hander nationally by that same service. So you know what kind of credentials he brings. And again, things might have worked out differently on the draft weekend last year, and he may not have ended up at Clemson, but Eric Backage uses him as a great example of a guy, and these days you see it all over the place. The time he spends here at Clemson may get him ready for pro ball better than if he'd gone to pro ball right out of high school for so many reasons. And not only as a baseball player.
Exactly.
But just personally, you're
able to handle that life.
And you're kind of in a daily deal, and you're getting, you know, the meals and all the benefits that this program offers, the campus life, and just kind of being able to round in as a young adult to adulthood. Pearson.
Well,
and
I think the other thing, Pete, is that often guys in high school, they start in low A ball or even rookie ball, which is a half season. So guys that come out of college usually start in high A. Plus you get some education under your belt and I think some a maturity level because, you know, pro baseball is I knew a lot of guys that didn't handle that life very well.
Almost half of MLB rosters on a shot. Blackwell takes the high hop. Second one over to first. Safe. Pearson, good speed to beat it out. Two away.
Yeah, Bertram did kind of nonchalant at that. Thought it was an easy double play. And that ball needed to be zipped over there. And Pearson showed some really good speed going down that line. And I think, you know, Bertram's like, wow, you know, I needed to be a little quicker with that turn. And we know he can do that. He turned a really nice double play yesterday. And
two outs, man on first. Almost half of your MLB rosters right now are made up of players from 4-year colleges. So they went to college for at least 3 years, in some cases two, because there's an age loophole there when you can get drafted after 2 years. Runner on the move, Pearson, throw down, Engel, out.
Woo.
Boy, Engel's done a nice job today. Woo. Got a runner trying to seal second in the first, gets Pearson here to close out the top half of the third inning. Cooper Engel, he's been fierce with his bat. His arm has been mighty in the series as well.
This isn't us. Is it?
Uh-huh.
Let's take a break from our devices for 5 days, 5 hours, or even just 5 minutes. And let's see what we find.
Hey, bud.
U.S. Cellular. Built for us.
Every parent knows when it's time to go into protect mode. Adding Lysol laundry sanitizer kills 99.9% of illness-causing bacteria detergents leave behind. Clean is good. Sanitized is better.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it.
Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot.
The SEC Championship at 1, then the American Athletic Championship, Sunday on ESPN. SEC Championship at 1, then the American Athletic Championship, Sunday on ESPN.
Hi, I'm here for...
your annual eye exam.
Exactly. I'm here because I'm having trouble...
reading.
Exactly.
They sort of make me feel...
like I'm the most fabulous thing you've ever seen? Like lightning is running up and down your spine?
Exactly.
I'll take them.
Kubrengel getting ready to bat second here in the Tigers' half of the third inning. Little fellow over his shoulder, probably congratulating him on the nice throw he made. Gunned down a second runner trying to steal second base in this ball game. Tigers start out with Cam Cannarella. Leadoff hitter. Has hit in each of his 14 collegiate games. Takes strike one. Reached in the first with a leadoff walk. Eventually stole second. Was left stranded there. Tigers had him first and second with just one away. But Cameron Landry able to work out of that jam. Just one hit in the game so far. That was by the Tigers. And that one smacked to short. Ruiz to first. And they get Cannarella by half a step for out number one.
Cannarella showing his speed down the line. Hard hit ball to the left of Ruiz, and he lost his footing a little bit. I don't know if we'll see this, but he was able to see him slip a little bit, still have the arm strength to get him by less than half a step. Boy, good call by the umpire. That was close.
Engel caught looking his first time up.
Good looking little fastball that started inside and had a little arm side run over the inside corner. You see the shift for Georgia State defensively. If we can take a look at that, they've got three guys on the right side of the infield and the third baseman, the only guy on the left side of the infield. And I find that interesting because Cooper handles the bat so well, he can drive the ball to all fields. But the analytics apparently say that he's pulling the ball most of the time.
So they say. 3-1 the count.
Ooh, just missed.
Tiger Jr. out of Asheville working on an 8-game hitting streak. 13 for his last 32. Top of the zone, count goes full.
Three-one count. That was a good pitch to hack at. Surprised that he didn't take an aggressive swing there.
Stays alive.
Yeah, there's an example of a young man having confidence in his breaking pitch, throwing that 3-2 curveball, and I think that's indicative of the fact that it is his best pitch.
Might have chased.
Yep. But you'd rather see that than, you know, taking that third strike. And I think after taking the third strike in his first at bat, he's going to be a little more protective.
Again, a 3-2 pitch to the Tigers catcher. And a one-out base runner. Third walk issued by Landry. Will Taylor was one of those to reach on a free pass. Came in the first inning with one away at the time. Tigers had runners on first and second. Landry worked out of the jam with a pop up to first off the bat of Amick, and then got Riley Bertram to fly out to center.
Yeah, there were actually two walks in that inning, and that often leads to some runs being scored.
Engel on the Bates pass this season has yet to attempt a stolen base. Tigers, though, have been aggressive under the early reign of Eric Backich, and that's lined through the left side. First and second now. Second hit of the game. Taylor, the one-out single. The Tigers again have something going.
Yeah, fastball over the middle part of the plate. And you can see Taylor just dropped the bat head on the ball and drive it in the six hole.
He came up at the bottom of the ninth on Friday with the bases loaded. Billy Amick stands in now, his second plate appearance.
What happened?
And something good happened for the Tigers. And here he is now, first and second, one away in the third. Amick popping out to first in the opening inning. And first pitch swinging, that's through the left side. Let's see if they wave the runner. No, they'll hold Engel at third, and the bases will be loaded. Amick coming through with another hit in the series. This one not as dramatic, but he's now 3-for-5 against Georgia State pitching this weekend.
And normally for a third base coach, if the outfielder has the ball in his glove prior to the runner from second base touching third base, he's going to hold him up. Unless, of course, there are two outs, and then you're going to be more aggressive.
Visit to the mound by Chad Bell, the Georgia State pitching coach. Trying to settle down Landry, who had worked out of first and second one-out issue in the opening inning, and then Tigers had a man in scoring position in the second. Nathan Hall, who had the first hit of the game for Clemson, was left stranded. Looked like we're going to get some stirring in the Georgia State bullpen. Left-hander getting up. Jaden Anderson, or actually that's the right-hander Duncan Lutz, but Landry, after the visit, will now focus.
watch this.
When you watch me play, you support all of us.
You show your daughter her future matters.
Take the shot.
Drive. Team up. Win.
When you watch me play,
you prove we deserve more media coverage.
When you watch the game, you change the game.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. You know it didn't come to play. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now's the time to get in and get away. Get 0% APR financing plus zero payments for 90 days on select Hyundai vehicles.
Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price when you sign up for multiple lines. But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you
no,
need.
No, you hang up.
U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Hello? Hello? Oh, I'll have another. Make it a double.
Who are you talking to?
Vincent, my server. He's from San Diego.
Dad, Mom thinks she's at a resort again.
Yeah, she told me.
When you'd rather not resort to a virtual resort...
This is much better in real life.
It matters where you stay.
Looking good, babe.
Extra chairs.
Oh, thanks, Steve. You're not from San Diego, are you?
No, ma'am.
Hilton, for the stay.
With Ron Smith, Pete Yannity back at Doug Kingsmore Stadium, Nathan Hall and others in that inning coming through for Clemson. And it's been an issue at times with men in scoring position, but both Bertram and Hall delivering just when the Tigers needed them.
Yeah, they had left three guys on first two innings, but certainly not that inning. Very, very solid inning for the Tigers offensively.
Cameron Jones, right fielder, began the game with a walk, was later caught stealing. Mm. And Tristan Smith gets one to swing through an 88-mile-an-hour pitch high in the zone. So Smith now stands out there. Stake to a 5-0 advantage, looking for his first career win after he had many of those in his high school days at Boiling Springs.
And that was his best breaking pitch. Really good looking breaking pitch to get him in front of the count. And this, you know, this the Clemson coaching staff looking to get, you know, you want to, as a pitcher, you want to, after scoring five, you want to get your team back into the dugout again and keep that momentum going.
Into center field, first hit of the game for the Panthers. Jones starting things out here for Georgia State in the fourth inning. So after having to rinse off that heartbreak last night, Panthers trying to now turn the tables on Clemson.
Yeah.
Tigers rally from a late six-run deficit and from four down to the bottom of the ninth inning to get that 9-8 win. Still plenty of time, and again, a dangerous lineup. You look all over their lineup and you see impressive slugging percentages.
Yep, numbers.
Guy at the place, Ryerson, among the national leaders in homers last season with 22. OPS coming in of better than 1,300. And just like that, he could change the momentum in a hurry. Went down swinging his first time up. One of three to strike out against the Tigers freshman left-hander.
You know, I continue to watch Tristan Smith and his very easy, smooth, mechanically sound delivery. And the ball just seems to get on hitters quickly. He's like some people would describe it as sneaky fast. And I think it's because of his effortless delivery.
Poise a big part of his makeup, says his head coach. And guy who touches 90 to 92, but could probably get up in the mid-90s, eventually will.
Boy, he gets behind a very, very dangerous hitter here. 3-1. This is a big pitch, and I like Cooper going out there to remind him of that. Well, you know, you just can't throw this one right down the middle. We could have a, you know, 5-2 game before you know what happened, so. Continue to pitch. Don't give in.
A lot of movement on his fastball. And whether you're a righty or a lefty, Eric Bankage will tell you, against Tristan Smith, there really isn't a true advantage because of that movement he gets. It can be really difficult for a righty batter. Just obviously as a lefty, but some trouble here to start things out in the fourth inning. The leadoff single, followed by the walk. That's the third issued by Smith.
And he's up to 60 pitches already as well. Just neither pitcher have been real efficient. You know, we talked about it's preferable to have a 3 or 4 pitch ground out than a 6 pitch strikeout.
Matt Ruiz, the shortstop, chops it away for strike one. 1 for 5 in the game last night, but that was his third home run. Ruiz, the USF transfer. First season with the Panthers.
And give credit to these Georgia State Panthers bouncing back after giving up 5 runs in the bottom of the third, and they're coming out here and saying, well, you know, we're going to answer.
And he gets ahead in the count, 2-1.
Not a bad pitch.
Georgia State entering the ball game in their first 14 games, 126 runs scored. So 5 run deficits for them are not
anything. Child's play.
That's all alarming. And once again, we will see another visit of the mound by Jimmy Bellinger, the first-year Clemson pitching coach, veteran of the game. And with a young pitching staff and a staff that has a lot of guys trying to define roles, great effort last night out of the bullpen by Nick Hoffman following Rocco Reed. Tigers really impressed how Hoffman was able to work out of some trouble. Clemson's bullpen was able to, you know, put the plug in the dam, so to speak.
Exactly. The Panthers had scored 2 runs in 4 innings in a row.
Yes.
And they did not score the rest of the game. And over the last 5 innings, only 2 runs given up by the Tiger bullpen.
2-2 now on Ruiz.
Big hack.
After the 5th inning, no Georgia State runs, and as a result, Tigers were able to mount that late rally. 7 runs in the final 2 innings. Clemson got a 5 spot in the home third, but here in the top of the 4th, 2 on, nobody out. The count goes full on the third place hitter in the Panthers lineup.
Now, Coach Bellinger, I'm sure, said, look, you gave up the leadoff hit. That's fine. Stay with your stuff. You don't have to do anything special here. Keep battling. Keep throwing strikes.
Jack Leggett alongside Eric Bakich. High to left. Pretty well hit. Hall at the hill. At the wall. Fair or foul? It's foul.
Whew, that was close.
The wind blowing in from center might have impacted it ever so slightly.
Yeah, there might have been a little hook spin on that, and then with the wind blowing in, it's going to exacerbate how much the ball moves. But that was very close.
Ruiz floating one up there in the sky, and the wind doing some work with it. Almost hit his 4th home run of the season. Obviously would have changed the look of this game in a hurry. Again, a 3-2 pitch. Tristan Smith delivering his 67th of the game. And that one's ripped on the left side, but foul.
And, you know, this is what Georgia State has done so well so far in this ball game. You look back at Jones, the leadoff hitter, to start the game at a 12-pitch at bat. And now you've got, this will be the third 3-2 pitch that Tristan Smith has to make.
And the bases are loaded and still no one out here in the top half of the 4th inning. 2 straight walks after the leadoff single and first hit of the game for the Panthers by Cameron Jones.
Now, we've talked before, you know, when you get bases loaded, no one out, if you can hold them to less than 2 runs in this situation, then you normally say, okay, we'll take that. And if that were the case, you still have got a nice lead.
Reed Garris starting to get loose, a sophomore righty for the Tigers in the bullpen. Dangerous hitter here, JoJo Jackson. Another one of those guys in their lineup with some big numbers.
Yeah, there is a good pitch.
Leads them in home runs so far with five. Had a five RBI game against Presbyterian in their series last weekend. Driven home 14 on the year. You know, this Georgia State athletic program sits right there in the middle of downtown Atlanta. You throw a dart in any direction 15 miles from their campus, and there are all-American high school baseball players.
No doubt.
All over the place.
That
I mean,
is a...
They bring in guys from other places, but this guy came from Stone Mountain. Much of their lineup is from either the state of Georgia, but Metro Atlanta. I mean, they're
right.
Sitting on a gold mine.
No doubt. People come from all over the country to recruit that area.
So Brad Stromdahl knows that he's potentially got a sleeping giant. He's done a nice job in building up this program after coming in from Georgia Gwinnett, an NAIA program that he turned into a powerhouse. High in the air to center field. Actually more toward right center now. Abrams, runner at third, will tag. Won't draw a throw, and Jones comes across with the first run of the game for the Panthers.
Good choice. Now possibly had Abrams gotten around that ball and instead of catching it as he was running towards second base, had he gotten behind it and, in other words, circled it and had his momentum going towards home plate, he might have been able to make a play at the plate. But good move to keep the runner at second base and not allow him to get to third with less than two outs.
First and second now with one away. Will Mize, the third baseman. Another dangerous hitter. Has a batting average up in the neighborhood of 350. 0 for 5, though, last night. And he went down on strikes his first time up today. 1-1 the count. Mize can play some first for them. Out of Snellville, Georgia. Went to Brookwood High right there in the Atlanta area. 2020 in a shortened season. Collegiate baseball freshman All-American. And ahead in the count, 2-1.
Yeah. You know, one of the challenges at Georgia State and Coach Brad Stromdahl is they play out on the perimeter, not far from the airport. And their campus is downtown. They really would like to get something downtown, facility downtown. And I think that would really give them a leg up.
Right center field. Abrams on the run. And it's gone. Or is it off the top of the wall? Looked like it got out. Everyone wearing blue is indicating that. It appears it hit behind the orange line and then bounced back in. And I think we're getting a review. I have a feeling that Will Mize has just left the yard for Georgia State.
Yeah, they're gonna have to take a look at that.
Looks like he just hit his fifth homer of the year. He stands at second right now. Just one run came in. Brad Stromdahl out there asking for the review. And let's take a look. It appears, and you see the woman.
No, that stayed in the park. No, that is the right call.
I noticed the woman flinching. I thought the ball went right behind her.
Right there. It
right
stayed
off the
in
top
the park.
Of the wall.
Yep. Wow. Talk about a game of inches. That is the correct call.
So it is the correct call.
That won't take them long to figure that out.
So, and of course, last night there was a huge video replay both head coaches talked about
today.
Very
impactful.
And saying, video told the story, but that obviously impacted the game. Boy, it appeared from my view and based on Abrams' body language. That the way he reacted, it appeared just seeing how, and just seeing live and in person, maybe on review, you won't see Abrams react. But it appeared he just kind of thought that ball was out of the park. So I apologize. It's going to turn into an RBI double, and it'll only be a 5-2 game with second and third and one away.
Yeah, a little surprising that Ruiz didn't score on that because obviously the ball was not going to be caught by the outfielder. It would have been an incredible play had he done so.
Second hit in the inning, two across for Georgia State, but they're right back
to this
game.
Point. Yeah.
And they've got runners on second and third, just one away.
I just don't see how they can't uphold this call.
I think you and I both thought that was out.
I did.
Yeah. Got the impression. I kind of overreacted because it appeared, it looked like the ball disappeared, and my thought was that it probably hit a seat and then ricocheted right back up and over. And it will stand as an RBI double.
Yep.
Off the bat of Mize.
Good call by the umpires again. Well done. That's not an easy call either.
Fifth RBI of the season for Mize. I take that back, rather. A 16th RBI of the season for Mize.
Again, there are no holes in this lineup.
No.
I mean, they got guys up and down the lineup that can produce. And again, now you got Strickland, who hit the massive home run. Boynton comes up after him, who had two home runs yesterday. Really big, strong, physical guys.
Dylan Strickland will not face Tristan Smith. Pitching change for the Tigers. We'll give it to you when we come back.
Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price when you sign up for multiple lines. But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you need.
No, you hang up.
U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Hello? To the adventurers, the builders, the farmers, the do-it-yourselfers, whether it's your first Silverado or your 10th, thank you for making Chevy Silverado the number one best-selling retail full-size pickup.
So, in your past relationships, you felt controlled.
Exactly. But it's over. I'm never going back. Now that I have Sling. Hey.
Let's unpack that.
With Sling, I'm finally the one in control because I can change my channel lineup anytime.
Do you and Sling share a love language?
If live sports and news is a love language, then yes! Yes! 1,000 times! Yes! Oh.
Sling, the live TV you love.
Sling. The Sport Clips MVP haircut experience is like nothing else in the world. And now, it's better than ever.
It's a perfectly steamed hot towel, infused with our signature scent. A 7-point massaging shampoo. And neck and shoulder, Nirvana.
Oh yeah. The MVP haircut experience, only at Sport Clips.
Reed Garris on in relief of Tristan Smith. Seventh appearance of the season. You see the numbers.
Yeah, really
12
impressive.
Strikeouts
yeah.
in seven innings of work, and the Tigers could really use that right now. Yeah. Second and third for Georgia State. Two runs already in. Looked like it might be a much tighter game than that off the bat of Mize, who, as it turns out, hit a noisy double that drove home just one run. But Georgia State threatening. And for Tristan Smith, giving up the first two runs of his collegiate career, and he won't factor in the decision as Smith, the talented left-hander, was making his third career start. 3 1/3 innings, 3 strikeouts, allowed 2 hits, both in this inning, but the 4 walks are what probably will really have him gnashing his teeth.
Especially the 2 in this inning, but you know, he faced an all right-handed batting lineup. No lefties in their lineup, and that's they have a right-handed dominated lineup, and you've got a lefty that is pretty good, but you know, that's a bit of a disadvantage for the pitcher.
Dylan Strickland, who popped out to the shortstop Blackwell to close out the second inning, stands in, and he skies on the left side again. Blackwell initially calling off Bertram, and then Bertram is the one who said, "I've got it last." Out number 2. One pitch, one out for Garris on in relief of Smith. Leads up to Luke Boynton, doesn't get much easier. Got to be the most imposing 7-hole hitter in the country, if not one of them.
Yes, he is just physically just a big, strong guy. And gets a fastball up and away that's called a strike on him, and Moynton's a little bit incredulous about that one. Ah, there's a nice slider.
Gets ahead of him 0-2. Moynton flied out to right in the third. 10 homers a year ago, or top 10 in homers in the Sun Belt Conference a year ago. He had a dozen. 0-2.
Tried to climb the ladder there. Either that or he got a, really got under a slider that just kind of hung there. Fortunate that it was well up out of the strike zone.
Power at the plate. Representing a would-be tying run. Stays high. Count evens 2-2.
Now that's a close pitch. Cooper Engel did a nice job of making that look better than it was.
Boynton awaits a 2-2. Swing and a miss. Tolji Garris, a strikeout guy. Does a nice job to put out the fire here in the Georgia State third. Gets a pop out, gets a strikeout. And the Panthers limited just two runs. Head to the bottom of the fourth in a 5-2 game.
There are all kinds of products in this world. Things that make life easier or more fun. But New York Life's product is different. It's 12,000 experts whose responsibility is to be there to guide you through the happiest and most difficult times. All things in what we do. Our product. This is what we do.
Hey, Seth. You getting ready to roll?
Yep, road trip. And now that I'm rolling with Verizon, I get why more people choose it.
Nice.
And I got this incredible iPhone 14 Pro on them.
Oh, love the camera. So you got an amazing network and save money doing it.
That's how I roll. Oh, no.
You like your keys in the car again?
Yeah, I did.
Switch now and get iPhone 14 Pro on us. There's more. You get Apple Watch SE and iPad, all three on us. That's a value of up to $1,700. But hurry, this offer won't last long. Get the savings you want on the network you deserve. Verizon.
Hi, I'm here for...
Your annual eye exam.
Exactly. I'm here because I'm having trouble...
Reading.
Exactly.
They sort of make me feel...
Like I'm the most fabulous thing you've ever seen? Like lightning is running up and down your spine?
Exactly.
I'll take them.
It appears someone is feeling incredibly comfortable at the old ball game. Early in her career of Clemson fandom.
Yeah.
That guy, he's a grizzled veteran, all things compared. Tigers dodging what could have been much worse in the top half of this fourth inning. 9-1-2 due up here in the bottom of the fourth. Max Starbuck flied out to center back in the second inning. Another start for him at third in place of Blake Wright, who's out with illness. Shows bunt, pulls back, and the count goes 1-1. So you're feeling a whole lot better about things if you're Cameron Landry.
Yeah.
Got touched for five in the third inning, including the three-run blast by Nathan Hall. First career home run for the Tiger freshman outfielder. But a couple of runs in the top half. And again, a dangerous Georgia State lineup. They're picked way down in the Sun Belt. And again, Sun Belt Conference, one of those leagues you overlook. Southern Miss picked to win it, but with Georgia, Southern, Coastal, Carolina, a bunch of teams with pedigree that have been to Omaha. Of course,
yeah.
Coastal
won it.
Won their national title. That was the very last thing they did as a Big South program, but immediately came to the Sun Belt. And Starbuck, a leadoff base runner, reaching by way of a hit by pitch.
Well, I can tell you that Cameron Landry is kicking himself in the tail right now. And a little surprising. I mean, it was almost like that elbow. Oh, almost like that elbow got stuck out there a little bit and inducing that hit by pitch.
By the way, our friends of the Cajun Cafe have their own DoorDash service as well.
I couldn't help it. I had to react when I saw that.
We just looked over our shoulder, and that's, I mean, quite frankly, if anything's going to take your attention away from what's going on the field. And incredibly reasonable rates, too. I mean, I don't know how they're making a profit down there. It's a business model they're probably going to have to review. Top of the order, Cam Cannarella, working on a nice start to his Clemson career, hitting in his first 14 games, led off at the bottom of the first with a walk, was left stranded after stealing second. Grounded out to shortstop his last time up. On a nice play by Ruiz to get him by half a step. Every time you talk to Eric Bakich about his freshman outfielder, you hear about the patience and the poise. We told you at the outset of the telecast, he and Cooper Engel each with five hits in the game last night. Count goes 3-1. First time that's happened for a Clemson tandem in a game since 1982.
Yeah.
Under the late, great Bill Wellhelm. As Brooks Shoemake and Jimmy Key delivered in that game for the Tigers. Another walk for Cannarella. Two men reaching without a hit so far here in the fourth. Hit by a pitch Starbuck. And a second free pass in the game issued to Cannarella.
You got to think that Cameron Landry is on his last hitter or close to it. His pitch count up to 82 and hit a guy after getting in front. And then misses the strike zone pretty badly on three of the pitches and ends up walking Cannarella.
Well, they used five pitchers out of their bullpen last night. You see activity going on there. And they continue to have Duncan Lutz warm up, the right-hander.
I don't know, but with this Cajun Cafe food sitting in front of me, you know, one of the unique things here at Doug Kingsmore is it's so much character.
It really
is. You know,
is.
In this stadium, and one of them is the Cajun Cafe out there, and the wonderful folks who do that cooking, and boy, those people, they have a nice time out there.
Popular place. You
so
see
cool.
The cooking area over there to the left. Skilled chefs of the barbecue sciences, and they make a nice french fry out that way, too.
Oh, my gosh.
We are going to get a pitching change as the head coach, Brad Stromdahl, made the trip. And they will go to a left-hander, will the Panthers. Tell you about him when we come back here in Clemson.
Hey, Seth, you getting ready to roll?
Yep, road trip. And now that I'm rolling with Verizon, I get why more people choose it.
Nice.
And I got this incredible iPhone 14 Pro on them.
Oh, love the camera. So you got an amazing network and save money doing it.
That's how I roll. Oh, no.
You like your keys in the car again?
Yeah, I did.
Switch now and get iPhone 14 Pro on us. There's more. You get Apple Watch SE and iPad, all three on us. That's a value of up to $1,700. But hurry, this offer won't last long. Get the savings you want on the network you deserve. Verizon.
Kids are so expensive, Dad. Now Katie needs braces.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
I don't know, Dad.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
It's a great idea, TV Dad.
But I said the exact same thing.
Someday when you're a father, you'll understand.
I'm his father.
It's not a competition.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
The three for me only at Chili's gets you a bottomless drink, bottomless chips and salsa, an entree like a cheeseburger and fries, the chicken bacon ranch quesadilla, or a steak with loaded mashed potatoes starting at just $10.99. Wait a minute, that can't be right. Rewind. So you get a drink, all the chips and salsa you can eat, a giant entree, and a side starting at just $10.99? Oh, someone's gonna get in trouble for this one. This Chili's 3 for Me is the best $10.99 you can eat.
Second appearance in the series for Aiden McAllister, the senior left-hander, last night, inning in a third. Phase 5. Six batters and struck out two of them and on a relief. And again, Brad Stromdahl will not be hesitant to use that bullpen. And after his team got a couple in the top half of the fourth inning, looking shaky here in the bottom half of the Tigers with Starbuck and Cannarella reaching. On a hit by a pitch and a walk, and the left-handed batter Cooper Engel up. Naturally, you go to the left-hander McAllister.
And he is in there for not just to face Cooper Engel. I mean, he's going to be they're going to want to get a couple of innings out of him, if at all possible, because, again, he used six pitchers last night. Their bullpen was stressed a little bit, and now only able to get three innings out of their starter today. So he's got some shuffling to do, some chess playing to do here with his pitching staff.
Well, a tough start for Cameron Landry, trying to bounce back from a loss last week against Presbyterian. So far, five runs allowed on five hits for him. Of course, the two base runners, his responsibility.
Well, now you get to the heart of this Clemson order. That's a good looking pitch there, called down, but boy, that's a good pitch.
Engel got things going with one out in the bottom of the third. Reached on a walk. And then came around on the Riley Bertram two-run single.
And you know, McAllister is a guy who not going to throw hard. He's just going to kind of mix things up, throw the changeup, spot his fastball, throw the big breaking pitch. Probably uses his changeup more against right-handers than he does against lefties. He's going to use the breaking pitch more as an off-speed pitch. And there's his fastball at 83, Pete.
2-1 the count. Of course, Engel not only with an RBI single as part of the rally in the ninth inning last night, but the two-run homer in the eighth that began Clemson's late surge. 7 runs in the final 2 innings, and strike 2 delivered to even the count.
You're probably going to see that big breaking ball now. McAllister able to slip a couple of fastballs in there, and again, he pitches off of his breaking pitch. There it was.
Marchman keeps it in front, so the count goes full. Mind you, on a Tiger team that, by recent standards, not hit a lot of home runs so far this season. 12 playing here in their 15th game. Engel, the team leader in that category, with 4 of them.
Interesting to see if they start to runners here.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss.
Fastball in.
Tough guy to strike out.
Yeah.
7th time.
Really?
This season coming into the game. Now, 8th time he's struck out this year.
Really well located. Fastball down and in. Engel got tied up.
First out of the inning. Will Taylor has walked. Reached on a single. Taylor with some family in the stands today. Of course, not a bad drive at all. He's from the Midlands. Taking strike 1. Four for 6 in the series, Will Taylor. Has also reached on a couple of walks. And the count evens 1-1.
Well, Aiden McAllister, he has to be a pitcher. I mean, he cannot miss over the middle part of the plate. He's got to locate, and he is a senior. He's been experienced, so he knows how to change speeds and throw strikes with his off-speed stuff.
Off-speed that time, 70 miles an hour. McAllister out of Suwanee, Georgia. Came to them from Georgia Southern. Played at Lambert High. Two and one on the Tigers' D.H. Taylor. Gets a piece. Count evens 2-2.
Again, maybe a bit of a changeup, but just really well located. He just does not miss down the middle of the plate very often. As a hitter, your approach has to be up the middle and the other way, I think.
First baseman Amick waiting on deck. Just one away here in the Tigers' fourth after they got 5 in the third.
Got it.
Called strike 3. Inside corner, 2 away.
Well, again, pitching off of his breaking ball, and he's looking for something off speed, and he is able to throw that fastball to both sides of the plate. You saw him strike out Cooper Engel with the fastball on the inside part against a lefty, and he came right back and got Taylor with the fastball inside versus a righty. So he's controlling both sides of the plate with his fastball.
Amick singled and scored his last time up in the third.
Boy, if you talk about doing a job, if he can get through Amick here without giving up a run. But started out as a promising inning.
Chop to the shortstop, Ruiz, slipped to second. And a really nice job out of the bullpen by Aiden McAllister. Keeps things right here, a 5-2 game.
How do I do it all? With a little help. And to support my family's immune health, I choose Airborne. Unlike some others, Airborne gives you vitamin C and so much more. It's an 8-in-1 immune support formula. Airborne, do more.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now's the time to get in and get away. Get 0% APR financing plus zero payments for 90 days on select Hyundai vehicles.
Did you ever stress about us having three kids?
No. I was always part of the plan.
Three kids? This was never part of the plan. These kids order the lobster mac and cheese. What if she wants to play golf? We're gonna have to outlaw golf. Absolutely no golf in this house. Not under my roof.
Since we started working with Empower, all of our financial questions have been answered, so we don't have to worry.
So you never...
Nope, always part of the plan.
Join 17 million people and take control of your financial future to Empower What's Next. Start today at empower.com.
Meet Febreze's Miracle Spray, Febreze Fabric Refresher. I literally use this every day to make my house smell amazing. After I make the bed, after I catch my dog on the couch, so I can wear my jacket or jeans one more time before I wash them again. It even makes shoes smell fresh. It doesn't cover up odors with scent, but actually fights them and freshens. Over 1,000 uses. Febreze Fabric Refresher.
As you watch this video, mind you, Aiden McAllister just had success out on the mound. That is one pump pitcher. Yeah, great job in relief. Came in a jam after his team had whittled into a 5-0 deficit. Yeah. Aaron's a first and second. No out situation. Gets Ingles swinging, Taylor looking, and then Amick to ground in to a fielder's choice. Garris back on for a second inning of work. He worked out of the jam. In the top half of the fourth inning, when Georgia State had to settle for two runs.
He did a good job. So both bullpens have done their job to this point.
Catcher Marchman walked and then was retired at second base. On a fielder's choice in his first plate appearance. Back in the third, top of the fifth, skied out of play. 1-2 the count. Marchman, the third catcher to play this weekend for the Georgia State team.
Oh, really got under that one. Elbow got out in front, dropped his elbow, and just cannot get on top of the ball when you do that.
Two two.
Again.
Stays high.
Got to get on top of it.
Marchman, a junior out of Loganville, Georgia.
Good pitch.
Got him. Plays beautifully, 90 miles an hour. Second strikeout for Garris.
Well, look at
two
that
in a row for him.
Yeah, look at that location, Pete. Just perfect.
See the Tigers team tally in strikeouts. Fifth by Clemson pitching. Dalton Pearson, the center fielder, reached on a fielder's choice and was caught stealing. One of two thrown out on the base pass so far by Cooper Engel. One of many in their lineup hitting better than 300.
Well, and one of the reasons is he runs so well. You saw him get down the line to beat out that what appeared to be an easy double play situation.
I think that ball slipped out of Garris's hand.
Basic 50-foot breaking pitch.
Two and one on Pearson. 3-1. He was 2-for-4 last night with a run scored. We're talking about it earlier. If this is a team picked down around 7th or 8th in the Sun Belt Conference, that's some kind of league with the lineup they can roll out there. Swing and a miss. 89 miles an hour. Count goes full. I think Garris has put down a marker that needs to be taken seriously out of that Clemson bullpen. Did he go? Yes. Appeal to the first base umpire, Steve Sanders. Three straight struck out. Now two out in the inning.
Yep, there's that fastball that just rides up. Hitters just cannot lay off of that. Sixth strikeout for the Tigers.
Top of the order, Cameron Jones delivered the first hit of the game for Georgia State. That came leading off the top half of the fourth inning. Hitter came home on a sacrifice fly by Jackson. Well hit right field. Abrams will give it a look as it sails foul. Jones hitting close to 300 when the day began. Preseason all Sunbelt Conference player. He got that hit in the fourth. It was his first against Clemson pitching over the past couple of years. Remember, Georgia State came in here last season, got a midweek win.
Yeah.
0-2 the count of the batter, Jones. Griffin Chaney, a three home run game in that Georgia State win. And it looked like they were going to make it two in a row in the series last night, obviously, before the late heroics by the Tigers over the final couple of innings. 0-2 pitch.
And basically, they have the same team back. You've seen Garris trying to throw that fastball, and maybe he's trying to overthrow it a little bit. That's what's gotten him behind. Obviously, here, 1-2, he's ahead of the hitter. But
right side, Bertram ranging to his left. Quick inning of work, three up, three down. Reed Garris and the Tigers head to the bottom of the fifth, up 5-2.
Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price when you sign up for multiple lines.
What? Multiple lines?
Hello? Yeah, one sec. But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
Just one line with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you need.
No, you hang up.
Are you even listening, guy who never looks up from his phone?
Oh, not for me, I just say it.
Okay, so no, you're not listening.
Get one line for $29.99, plus every plan is price protected. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Mom, can we get a puppy, Mom?
Please?
Girls, pets are a big expense.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
Thanks, TV Dad. We'll think about it, okay?
Look what I found.
A puppy!
Oh, no.
I wish TV Dad was always in charge.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
Just between us, you know what's better than mopping? Anything. At the end of a long day, it's the last thing I want to do. Well, I switched to Swiffer WetJet, and it's awesome. It's an all-in-one, so it's ready to go when I am.
The cleaning solution actually breaks down dirt and grime, and the pad absorbs it deep inside, so it prevents streaks and haze better than my old mop.
Plus, it's safe to use on all my floors, even wood.
Swiffer WetJet, so worth it. Best decision ever. Get $10 off for a limited time.
Well, someone's pacing himself. First of two here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium. Bad weather forecast for Sunday, so this three-game weekend series between the Tigers and Panthers concluding. You know, it's really not been a big series between the teams. Clemson leads it 2-1 as we start out here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. And Riley Bertram leads things off, but it makes a lot of sense. You know, they played
good
a midweek
series,
game.
Yeah.
Over the last couple of years, but non-conference series makes all the sense in the world. A short drive up from Atlanta for the Panthers.
Right.
And, of course, a lot of Atlanta area guys on the Clemson roster. So good for them to see a hometown team. And Bertram thrown out, kind of a low throw across by Mize. Nice job over at first by Boynton to dig it out. Out number one for the Tigers here in their half of the fifth inning.
And that was a nice play by Boynton, and he did that a couple of times yesterday. He's got pretty good hands over there. And sometimes when you have that much time, you get to thinking about it a little bit, and you kind of shot put it over there instead of letting it go.
Nathan Hall, biggest swing of his early Clemson career. Coming in that five-run third inning, a three-run blast, a no-doubter over the lower bleachers in left field.
Boy, Aiden McAllister really sharp here today.
Second inning of work for the lefty. A little bit of a delay in his delivery.
I like that. Just to throw off the timing. I mean, a hitter's responsibility is time the baseball, and a pitcher's responsibility is attempt to throw that off.
Shortstop Ruiz plays the second hop. And two up and two down for the Tigers. Here in their half of the fifth inning, that shot by Hall went over the lower seat area out there in left field, and a shot that left the park in a hurry. This time, nice shot by Ruiz. Tough hop coming off the seam with the grass and the dirt.
Boy, Hall got down that line pretty well.
Got a pinch hitter. Gavin Abrams was due up. Tyler Corbett, though, is going to get an opportunity. But will it be against McAllister? Corbett going back over. Rosin off the bat. Looking to break through here in 2023 as the Clemson transfer from the Citadel.
Well, he was part of that five-run ninth inning last night. He drew the walk. He had the leadoff base hit by Hall, and then a strikeout, and then the walk, and that put guys on first and second with one out. And then here comes Cantarella, Engel, Taylor, and boy, things changed.
Certainly didn't a hurry. 0-for-8 though in his senior season. Native of West Columbia. Pinch hitting for Abrams, who went down swinging in his first two plate appearances. Off speed, 66 miles an hour. This guy's a lefty through and through, Ron.
No doubt. Softy lefty, gotta love him.
And my eyes don't deceive, that was also 66 miles an hour.
Well, I love these guys that don't try to overthrow the ball. They pitch. They're going to hit corners, change speeds.
Right field. And Jones didn't have to move that far. Tigers going in order in their half of the fifth inning. Head to the 6-5-2.
Introducing new sweet and savory crepes. Whether you like the flavor of cinnamon bun after sunset or prefer to wake up to a little eggs and bacon, day or night, it's always time for crepes. Only from IHOP. Download the app and earn free food with every order. Flavors that are delicious any time of day. Only from IHOP. Download the app and earn free food with every order.
At Bon Secours, we believe your healthcare should always revolve around you. So no matter where you are, and at Bon Secours, we believe your healthcare should always revolve around you. So no matter where you are, in our offices or virtually, we'll be there with compassionate, personalized care. Bon Secours. Visit bonsecours.com to find a doctor near you.
To you, it may just be an elevator.
Here goes nothing.
But for a young homeowner becoming their parents, it's a learning opportunity.
Come on in. The more the merrier.
Paris, huh?
Bonjour.
We got any out-of-towners in the elevator?
Tom, it is not easy.
10th floor, huh? Must be a heck of a view.
Okay, See how everyone else is facing this way?
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home and auto with us.
Okay, that was terrible. Okay, let's hang back. We're going to try that again.
Head of the sixth inning, Tigers up 5-2 on Georgia State. First of two at Doug Kingsmore Stadium. We welcome you back in. Bit of an overcast day now, a cool March afternoon, but a great day to play, too, with Ron Smith, Pete Yannity. And a lot of activity from the bottom of the third to the top of the fourth. But Georgia State's lineup, one that you've really got to be careful against. And so far, Clemson pitching, Smith, and then Garris, and now another one coming on. But that's been the case to this point.
Well, the bullpen particularly has done a good job. Reed Garris came in and just shut things down beautifully for Clemson. And then after leaving four people on the first couple of innings, Clemson breaks through with the big base hits. And then, of course, the big home run by Hall.
Now let's take you to that home third inning. Tigers with a five spot as they got things going with the upper part of their order. Big two-run single delivered by Riley Bertram after Engel and Taylor had reached with one away. And then Nathan Hall, what a moment for him. After Billy Amick last night hit his first career homer, the walk-off grand slam, that's the first for the Lexington native. Hall, great day for him. Joe Allen, the new pitcher in the game for Clemson. Third use for the Tigers. Smith, the starter, will not factor in the decision. Amick, give him credit. Or I should say Garris, give him credit, came on in a real jam in the top half of the fourth when a couple were in and runners were on second and third for Georgia State. And Garris was able to work out of that jam.
Hey, he really pitched well. And a little surprised that they took him out because he was so effective.
Garris retiring the five batters that he faced, so he is the pitcher of record to the good for Clemson.
He may be able to be used in the second game today. I'm not sure how many pitches he threw, but it wasn't too many, maybe 20, 25.
And you would suppose that was part of the thinking?
I don't know.
Sky to center field. Cannarella putting it away. Max Ryerson retired here to start things out in the Georgia State sixth inning.
Boy, you always want to, when you face Ryerson, you want it to be we'd rather face him with two outs and nobody on, but it's always best to face him with no one on because he can take it deep just like that.
Matt Ruiz walked and was left stranded at third. His last time up, chopper charging Starbuck. Good throw, and it's quickly two up and two down here in the sixth. Ruiz retired. JoJo Jackson with a sac fly RBI. In the top half of the fourth inning, will stand in. It'll be strike one of the batter, Jackson. Allen on this season for a seventh time out of the Clemson bullpen. 11 strikeouts in now 9 2/3 innings of work. Tigers hoping he can continue the good work of the bullpen in this series. And he's had the count here. Two strikes and nothing. Allen a long way from home. Hampton Falls, New Hampshire.
Ooh.
Jackson, top power threat on this Panthers team, stays alive. Pretty good quarterback in high school at Stevenson High in the Stone Mountain, Georgia area to a 15-5 record as their starting quarterback, did Jackson.
Well, he looks athletic.
Another 0-2 pitch. And as a baseball player, he's been real good, the sophomore. Coming into the game today, a .343 batting average. Their team leader with five homers drove home his 15th run with a sac fly in the fourth, but goes down here swinging. More good work from the Tigers' pen. Allen gets him in order in the sixth. Clemson up 5-2. First of two on a Saturday at Doug Kingsmore Stadium.
Hey, Dad, look.
Us.
This is the magma chamber.
Uh-huh. This isn't us, is it? When did we get so connected to our devices and so disconnected from each other?
She's not answering.
What?
And when our phones have turned us into this,
LT,
what do you do when you're a company that sells them?
We gotta fix this.
It's time to find what we're missing. Join us.
Feels good.
And let's find us again. U.S. Cellular. Built for us. 5 hours or even just 5 minutes.
Feels good.
And let's find us again. U.S. Cellular. Built for us.
The Sport Clips MVP haircut experience is like nothing else in the world. The Sport Clips MVP haircut experience is like nothing else in the world.
And now, it's better than ever.
It's a perfectly steamed hot towel. Infused with our signature scent. A 7-point massaging shampoo. And neck and shoulder. Nirvana.
Oh yeah.
The MVP haircut experience. Only at Sport Clips.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it.
Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot.
Benjamin Blackwell leads off the Tigers' sixth inning. Real struggle for the shortstop. We've talked about it throughout the telecast today. 0-for-2 in this game. Tried to bunt for a base hit when he came up in the third inning after he went down swinging in the second. And behind in the count here, 0-2.
And I think that's a good thought. I mean, try to get something going with the bunt. What you really can't have happen is your defense is adversely affected because your offense is struggling. And to this point, we haven't seen that. So Blackwell's continued to play solid defense. He did commit an error yesterday.
And here he is facing a lefty in McAllister, who we have seen is as animated both on and off the mound as anyone you'll find. And a guy just tosses it up there and locates all over the place. Mize had a hard time handling it. It'll put it in his pocket. See how they score it.
That'll be a base hit. It's got to be.
And good feeling for Benjamin Blackwell. Sometimes it's moments like that that can get you turned back in the right direction.
Yep. I mean, that ball's hit hard. It just ate him up. Mize had very little chance. Brooks Robinson maybe makes that play.
Lead off single for the Tigers here. Mize, you see, talking to himself. Max Starbuck will stand in.
Thinking about the approach they want to take at this point here.
McAllister had retired the first six that he's faced as Starbuck talks things over with Eric Backage, Cannarella, among others listening in. See the Tigers try to play small ball here and get a runner in scoring position with his 3-run lead as we're in the middle innings. Eric Backage trying to have his team playing some good baseball ahead of conference play. 8-6 coming in today. And Starbuck showing bunt. And Blackwell chased back to first.
Yeah, I think, you know, a guy with Starbuck who has struggled a little bit at the plate, hitting in the 9-hole. This is a, I would say, playing it by the book.
Once again, shows bunt. Runner goes, throw down wide. Okay. Blackwell pops up. He'll head to third. He'll stand there with no one out. Stolen base and an error on the throw by the catcher, Marchman.
There's that additional weapon that the Tigers are utilizing this year, putting pressure. Show the bunt, pull it back. pick up two bases after the throwing error by the catcher.
Blackwell 11 of 14 now in the season in stolen base tries. Been among the national leaders throughout the year. Strike one taken by the batter Starbuck. Infield in for Georgia State here in the sixth inning, trailing by three runs with Blackwell over at third.
Now we've talked about this so many times. Just get that ball put in play with nobody out. You won't see the contact play from the Tigers at third base. You'll see the ball through the infield. If it's a ground ball, obviously you want to try to get a fly ball into the outfield deep enough.
1-2, McAllister trying to clean up the situation. Lined into center field. Pearson will see it fall in front. What a good time for Starbuck to come through with his first hit of the season. And he drives in his first run of 2023, and the Tigers have a 6-2 advantage.
Well, you see a fastball that's not located very well for McAllister, and Starbuck able to drill it into center field, scoring that run, and the Tigers doing a much better job today driving in runs than we saw yesterday.
Starbuck at first, still no one out in the inning. Top of the order, Cam Cannarella has reached twice by way of walk. Began the day 11 of his last 24, riding a 14-game hitting streak. Each of his college games, he's had at least one base hit. Of course, he had five last night. Tigers doing in this inning exactly what Eric Backich talks about. The time you're in the batter's box, your mission is to get from home plate back around to home plate. Blackwell reached on the infield single, stole second. The throw was wide by Marchman that got him over to third on the error. And then Starbuck coming through with that blooper into center field. 2-1 on Cannarella. Count evens 2-2. Guys at the top of the Tigers lineup today, really the only ones who've been consistently hitting, although Amick came and come through in a big. The umpire at first, Steve Sanders, indicating the ball was foul. Would have been a huge opportunity for Georgia State, but it did not get to the bag, so it only bounced in foul territory. Therefore, counts 2-2 on Cannarella. Back to first goes Starbuck. And obviously, the head coach of Georgia State, Brad Stromdahl, out to have a conversation with the home plate umpire, John Mary.
He's a low-key guy, even when he's not happy. He is polite. And there's an example of Cannarelli, what he can do. Just, he's fooled on a pitch, but he fights it off.
Tigers have turned the table in game two of this series. They're the team that jumped out in front and has a multi-run lead here in the middle innings. Cannarella thought about it. Count goes full. Starbuck bouncing over there. He'll chase him back with a throw.
Now, I wouldn't be surprised to see him going here. Cannarella just does not strike out very often. It's a chance you take. There he goes.
3-2 pitch. Runner was on the move. Doesn't matter. Third time in the game that Cannarella has reached on a free pass. That was the case when he came up in the fourth inning. Callister now with the run already in, first and second, no one out for the Tigers. Big opportunity in the game here. Cooper Engel has a chance to further distance the Tigers from the Panthers. Activity in the bullpen. We've seen Duncan Lutz, the right-hander, up earlier.
Yeah, they're Georgia State going over their bunt defense, and
Engel showing bunt. Right-hander Lutz might be getting ready for Will Taylor, who follows in the order after the left-hander Engel. Left-handed batting Cooper Engel so far in the game has walked and scored. That came in the middle of a called third strike in the first and a strikeout swinging in the fourth. Again, showing bunt and pulling back. Engel has yet to sacrifice this season.
Well, I do think this will be McAllister's last hitter. He's really pitched well, gotten himself in a bit of a jam here, but
one-one. Little flare into left field. They'll hold Starbuck at third. Good job by Jackson to get that back in. Bases loaded, no one out. And a run already in the home sixth inning for Clemson. That makes Blackwell's run an earned run. First hit of the day, sixth in the series for Cooper Engel.
He's doing a great job of playing a little pepper with the baseball with two strikes. Thought about and actually was trying to get a bunt down, a sacrifice bunt. Once he got to two strikes, they opened things up a little bit, and he was able to punch it into left field. And that's going to be it for McAllister.
So Duncan Lutz will come on in relief, and he will find himself quite a jam. Bases loaded, nobody out for the Tigers here in the home sixth inning, already with a four-run lead. We'll tell you all about Lutz when we come back.
Mom, can we get a puppy, Mom?
Please?
Girls, pets are a big expense.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
Thanks, TV Dad. We'll think about it, okay?
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average. Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly...
Señor Mayor, with this tower, I will make... Señor Mayor, with this tower, I will make Pisa world famous. And you?
Yeah, you're gonna see towers like this in Rome, in Venice, in Florence.
But this one's round.
No, I don't know. Maybe a Red Bull will help you see it from a different slant.
Yes, I got it. We'll build it like this.
Perfetto!
Red Bull gives you wings.
How does Mint Mobile afford to give you premium wireless for just $15 a month?
Than you
no,
need.
You hang up.
U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Aiden McAllister lifted here in the Tigers' sixth inning. We saw his reaction after he had success on the mound. Working out of a bit of a jam when he came on in relief in the fourth inning, and he was pushing things aside and so forth. Here he is, more reserved, although leaving a mess for the guy who's on in relief, Duncan Lutz. Just the second appearance of the season for the Georgia State junior right-hander.
Big physical guy, 6'4", 240.
Out of Homerville, Georgia, went to Clinch County High School. And you see five strikeouts in his lone appearance this year, three innings of work. He will inherit a bases-loaded situation.
Nobody out. And again, if from this situation, the Georgia State can hold the Panthers down to just, or hold Clemson down to just two more runs, I think they would take that at this point. But boy, you've got Taylor and you've got some good hitters coming up. And it's incumbent now upon the Tigers to put the ball in play and just, you know, get one run at a time, two at a time, but you've got to get runs here with runners on third and less than two outs.
And now Lutz here in the sixth. Of course, in game one of the series Friday night, Panthers used six pitchers. Their starter, Joseph Brandom, gave him four innings. Of course, another one to follow here this afternoon. So, obviously, Brad Stromdahl, their head coach, is aware of that. Will Taylor caught looking his last time up in the Tigers' five-run third. He singled and scored. He's also reached by way of a walk. Takes high, ball one. Taylor 3-for-5 last night. Tigers DH came into the weekend, 6 of his last 16. And coming into this Saturday on that particular role after the three hits last night.
Lutz, a mid-80s guy. He got with that one up to 90s, but got that slider. Kind of over the top. Pretty straight fastball. Panthers playing for the double play in the middle and playing the corners in. If they can, they'll go to home.
Take strike one.
Boy, that was a that was a good one to be hacking on. 2-0 pitch. You got to be looking fastball. Look pretty close to down the middle. I think he'd like to have that one back.
Guy that Lutz may think he can attack. 13 strikeouts so far this year for the Tigers, D.H. Taylor. And the 2-1 pitch. Count evens 2-2. And that was 87 miles an hour.
Had a little cut on that one. See if Taylor can put the ball in play.
Two, two. Marchman tried to frame.
Yeah, that was a little too far outside.
Taylor scored on the two-run single by Bertram. Back in the third, ahead of that three-run homer by Hall, as Lutz will look things over. And the payoff pitch. Right field, long run, and a fair ball. Two runs will score. Taylor pulls into second with a two-run double. The Tiger lead grows to 8-2. Jones really never had a chance to run that one down. It was
not at all.
Kind of spinning away from him. Will Taylor coming through with the big hit. Still no one out in the inning. A fifth double on the season for the Tigers DH. Give him 9 batted in.
Yeah, still that ball was not hit that hard, kind of off the end of the bat. Taylor inside outed that ball, but perfectly placed down the right field line.
Starbuck and Cannarella coming around. Engel now at third, Taylor at second. Opportunity here for Billy Amick to add to his weekend. 1-for-3 in the game. Singled and scored in the third. But of course, still riding cloud 9 after his final swing of Friday night. That's hit well to right field. Jones back on it. Hill, wall, off the right field wall. Engel scores easily. Taylor comes home. Amick going for 3. Got himself a triple. That's a first in his Clemson career as well. 10-2 game.
Yes, it has been a weekend of firsts for him. His first home run last night. Big triple here. Poor Jones there in right field for Georgia State. Not accustomed to the little hill that serves as the warning track. And you can, you know, in this Clemson outfield, you can see him as he approaches the wall, just absolutely loses his footing. Trips and falls, the ball caroms off of the wall, and Amick easily able to come into third base.
Seven batted in for Amick. Six within the past 18 hours or so.
And still nobody out.
Bertram delivered a couple of runs. First two for the Tigers in the five-run third. A 10-2 advantage. Tigers have now scored 19 runs in the series. And they were sitting on two runs as they came to bat in the bottom of the eighth last night. Mounting that late rally. Six runs down.
And, well, you know, early in that ball game, Pete, they just left so many guys on base and weren't able to come up with that big hit. Late in the game, obviously, that was not the case. And certainly it hasn't been the case so far today. Still nobody out.
Not what they were obviously hoping for out of Lutz. Billy Amick in the series with a homer, a single, and a triple. And a couple hits last night. Mize has room. That's out number one. Nathan Hall ripped one over this lower area of seats out in left center field in the third inning. Has also singled and grounded out to short. He has two of the Tigers' 10 hits.
Just a long inning for this Georgia State Panther club. They've been out there a long time and still only one out.
Two and oh the count. Hall began the game in left field, has since moved over to right. Miles an hour.
Hall came off that one just a little bit. Didn't keep that front shoulder in there well enough.
Long run for the second baseman, and good job by Strickland. Amick stays at third. Late to come cover home plate was the pitcher Lutz. So two away, but you get the impression the damage has been done with a couple of five-run innings for this Clemson team, and you figure, despite the pop in the bats of Georgia State, you got nine outs to get. Bullpen coming through so far this weekend. Hey, that was obviously the hope in that Clemson dugout.
Yeah, it really started, you know, yesterday in the sixth inning, and really have done a great job as this Tiger bullpen. And one of the concerns here coming in the beginning of this week after last weekend versus South Carolina when got a couple leads and weren't able to hold on.
Tyler Corbett's second plate appearance, flied out to right last inning. Ninth man to bat in this Tigers sixth inning. You notice the mustaches, and maybe you're familiar with the fact that Eric Backage has a no facial hair rule. It is mustache march. Swing and a miss. 2-1 on Corbett as the Tigers try to raise awareness for the fight against ALS, teaming with Eric Backage's alma mater, East Carolina, and doing so in the memory of His coach, the late Keith LeClaire, who the gentleman you see on the left side of your picture, Jack Leggett, was also very close to.
Coached him.
And Corbett sees the count go 2-2. 91 miles an hour that time. From the right-hander, who stands 6'4", 222. They really do have a bunch of guys who can post up, a bunch of 6'3", 6'4 guys, both on their pitching staff and in their lineup.
Physical team.
Corby goes down on strikes to close out the Tigers' sixth inning, but five come home as Clemson has a second five-run frame in the ballgame. Head to the seventh, 10-2 Tigers.
Let's do it.
Come on, Jack, get me.
Ooh, nice play.
At Ally, we're helping millions save more for the things that matter most.
I'll get back to work.
Hey. With an Ally.
I'll get back to work.
Hey. Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price. When you sign up for multiple lines.
What? Multiple lines?
Hello. Yeah, one sec. But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
Just one line with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you need.
No, you hang up.
Are you even listening, guy who never looks up from his phone?
Oh, not for me, I just say it.
Okay, so no, you're not listening.
Get one line for $29.99, plus every plan is price protected. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
BK Musa here, everyone say cheese. Classic bacon and spicy. Flame grill double on a toasted bun with the caramelized onions. Now I want one.
BK, have it your way.
To all the Chevy Silverado owners out there, the adventurers and the doers, to everyone who works hard and plays hard. Whether it's your first Silverado or your 10th. Thank you for making Chevy Silverado the number one best-selling retail full-size pickup.
Activity here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium and at McWhorter Stadium, the Tigers' beautiful softball facility. They have an invitational there this weekend. Already had some games there involving other teams, Clemson softball. A couple of ball games coming up, Jacksonville. And then UNCG, a Spartans team. The Tigers knocked off on Friday, 3-0. Boy, John Rittman has that softball team again on the roll, a top five program, just its fourth season of existence. Grounded to second off the bat. Michael McGinnis. Bertram throws him out.
I think the softball team is, 21-1? They've lost one game this year.
23-1 now,
yeah.
With the
My
two
goodness.
Wins yesterday.
Oh.
McGinnis was pinch hitting for Mize, and he rolls out. New catcher in the game, Jacob Jarrell, now behind the plate. Cooper Engle getting rest on this doubleheader Saturday. Jesse Donahoe making his first appearance. He stands in place of Strickland. Donahoe, a sophomore out of Columbus, Georgia.
I tell you, Pete, one of the things that Coach Ballinger has this Clemson staff doing is getting the ball, getting back on the rubber, getting their sign, and delivering a pitch. And I know it's somewhat a function of the new rule, but I really think it helps them defensively as well.
Allen knocks it down, the underhand flip. Allen came on in the sixth inning, retired the side in order, has a chance to do that in back-to-back frames. Luke Boynton has flied out to right and struck out. Power-hitting first baseman for this Georgia State team.
He does have power. Boy, he gets the bat hit through the strike zone so quickly. Does tend to strike out a little bit, but
in an 0-2 hole. Couple of home runs last night. Showed you that chart earlier. Bunch of big time exit velocity numbers for both teams in the home runs last night, 1-2. By the way, we mentioned Clemson softball. A new program for the Tigers this year, women's lacrosse. And earlier this afternoon, they knocked off a nationally ranked Duke team, 11-10.
Wow.
First ranked win in the history, the very early history of Clemson women's lacrosse. So congratulations to them. Well, Allen wanted that call, but quickly back to work. The adage from a great pitching coach from way, way back when, from a man named Ray Miller, who had a great run with the Orioles and Pirates, managed the Twins, I believe, briefly. Swing and a miss. Work fast. Change speeds. Throw strikes. Joe Allen, following that creed, gets the K to close out Georgia State here in the top half of the seventh. Seventh inning stretch time. Tigers trying to go back-to-back against the Panthers in game one of two.
In March, we move up ladders and into history. This is what you dream of.
Two words. March Madness.
This Sunday, it's the event of the year, the Oscars on ABC, with performances by Rihanna, David Byrne, Stephanie Hsu and Sun Lux, Lenny Kravitz, Diane Warren with Sophia Carson, Raul Sapligan, Caleb Oliva, and more, with awards for the greatest dreammakers of the year.
The Oscars.
And the Oscar goes to...
Jimmy Kimmel hosts the Oscars, live Sunday on ABC.
Join me for the least athletic event of the year, the Oscars.
Who will triumph when this year's greatest movies go head-to-head?
Thank you. It's the one that always goes to overtime.
The Oscars, live Sunday, March 12th on ABC.
Somebody quite stylish, not only his apparel, but his utensils here at the ball game. Enjoying the seventh inning stretch. Those two guys have to like what they've seen so far. Perhaps future Tigers on the field. 10-2 advantage for Clemson as we head to the bottom half of inning number seven.
Got a really nice crowd here today.
Tigers averaging well over 4,000 a game so far.
Chilly afternoon. But Tiger faithful out here in force. Love seeing the kids out here, man. And it's a great venue for very kid-friendly, and got the hill out there that kids often utilize. See a lot of guys, though, sitting here actually watching the game.
McGinnis stays in as the third baseman. He came on to pinch it in the top half of the inning for Mize. And Donahoe will be the second baseman. As he pinch hit for Strickland, and Brennan Hudson now behind the plate for Georgia State. That is a fourth catcher they've rolled out there this weekend. He replaces Marchman. Benjamin Blackwell reached on a single his last time up. Hard shot to third that ate up Mize. That could be just the thing that gets him going. Came into the day, one for his last 16. Has seen his batting average drop in the neighborhood of 280 after he got off to that hot start.
And that was the catalyst for that big inning, that five-run inning.
Tigers five in the third, five in the sixth. Georgia State answered with two in the top of the fourth. It appeared that would turn out to be just an RBI double for Will Mize, was going to be a three-run homer, but it turned out to be right off the top of the wall in right field above Gavin Abrams' reach. And that was a huge moment in the game.
Yeah.
That ball, it looked like it had gone out and come back in, but it actually went right off the top of the wall. Only one run scored in the play. Tigers limiting Georgia State to just two runs in what could have been a much bigger top half of the fourth inning. 3-2 the count now on the Tigers shortstop, Blackwell.
Boy, Lutz wanted that pitch, and I don't blame him.
Chopper going to work its way through. Ha. Talking about exit velocity with the head coaches before the game and get a 95 mile an hour exit velocity, you're going to have a 600 batting average. That's what Brad Stromdahl of Georgia State was telling me. That time, exit velocity didn't matter. It was finding the place where no fielder could get it.
And that's exactly how things go when you start swinging the bat a little bit better, or you think you are. That was a routine ground ball if it's 15 feet to the left or 15 feet to the right. But because it perfectly found a six hole, Blackwell has his second hit of the game.
Second straight inning, the Blackwells led off with a single. Max Starbuck coming through with his first hit of the year. That followed Blackwell in the sixth after the Tigers' top base stealer had made it from first to third when he stole second and advanced on an errant throw by the catcher at the time, Marchman. So Blackwell was at third with no one out. And Starbuck dunked one into center field, also picking up his first run batted into the season. And an 0-2 count here. Blake Wright, the regular Clemson third baseman, missing another day due to illness.
Certainly wish him well and hope that he didn't spread it to any of his teammates.
That one's ripped foul, but well out of play into the bullpen for Georgia State. That could be put in that bucket and used as a ball to warm up a relief pitcher.
Yeah.
Oh, and two on the Tiger third baseman Starbuck reaches out and stays alive. His dad was involved with the Clemson program for several seasons, I believe in the volunteer assistant role.
His hands, as he is getting ready to get to that trigger position, pretty active, waving that bat head around. As you can see, it's
second time he reaches on a hit by pitch. Third time on in the game for Starbuck, and the Tigers here in the seventh inning have first and second once again with no one out. Caught him right on that elbow padding, I believe, in the shield. Cam Cannarella been on base three times, each via the walk. Came home and scored. And the Tigers five run sixth inning, looking for his first hit in the game after he had five last night. Trying to extend his hitting streak to 15 in a row to begin his Clemson career. And he takes strike one.
You know, when you kind of wish when you're working on a hitting streak that you could save one of those hits from last night. Although the Tigers, as a team, needed every one of them.
Oh, one pitch. Lutz on in a second inning of work. Tried to get out of a jam created by Aiden McAllister last inning, but Tigers were able to get to him for a double and a triple to add to the lead. 1-1 pitch. And now the Tiger freshman out of Hartsville in a 1-2 hole.
Well, we've talked about his advanced approach. He really sees the ball deep, especially when he has two strikes. He is does a great job of, he just doesn't get fooled off us because he waits.
Again, the 1-2 from Lutz to Cannarella. You talk about big guys in the game and the sizable batters in the Georgia State lineup. Here's a guy listed at 6 feet 175. Yep. So talent comes in all sizes, obviously. And if you have a very level approach, which that's what he has, and advanced maturity for a freshman hitter, he can be really effective as he has so far. But that time, got him on an off-speed pitch. Frown number one here in the Tigers' seventh.
Backdoor slider. I think it was out of the strike zone. Not sure if how it would have been called, but just couldn't stay back long enough. Lutz with a good-looking pitch there.
A strikeout of a Tiger batter by Georgia State pitching. Big wave and a miss in his first time up in the game. Jacob Jarrell came on defensively for Cooper Engel in the top half of this seventh inning.
Well, that probably, given Cooper a chance to start this second game then, with him only catching half of the first game.
Ripped into left. It'll drop in front of Jackson. Tigers now have them loaded. Runner at second, Blackwell, had to wait to make sure that ball wasn't caught, so he holds the third. Starbuck at second. And Jarrell, who was one for his last nine before that plate appearance, has to feel good about that. Tigers now with 12 hits in the game and a chance to add to an already impressive 8-run lead. And Will Taylor would be just the guy to do that. Two-run double his last time up. He's also singled. That followed up a three-hit game on Friday. On the season, Taylor now with 9 batted in. Inducing the ground ball, Lutz, 10-2 Clemson, head to the eighth.
The insurance company only knows me by this claim number. Well, insurance company, I'm Max. I was hurt at work weeks ago and still no word from you about my claim. Nice to meet you.
Don't wait on the insurance company. Call Grimes Teich Anderson.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it. Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot.
This event gets better every year, and they're buzzing with excitement right now.
That was a good shot.
We'll see if they can avoid the water.
No chance.
Oh, yes! He knocks it in!
There's the scene over at 17.
Souvenir for a lucky fan.
It's a little tight. Makes me feel
husky. Husky like UConn. UConn Huskies with a buzzer beater to win it all. Oh.
Is everything okay?
Yeah.
kind of day where you need a jacket or a sweatshirt, but a pleasant day to be out of the ball game. Tigers were threatening to add on in the seventh, just the first double play grounded into this season by Will Taylor. Out of the Cajun Cafe, you can find some warmth and, of course, real good vittles. And thanks to the folks there for dropping off, ordered us today.
Oh, my.
Very
mercy.
Kind, very
That's all gracious. I can say about that. That food is so good.
First plate appearance in the game for Brennan Hudson, who came on at catcher last inning. Chopped on the right side. And Bertram on to first for out number one. So Jack Crichton now in the game in the outfield. Nathan Hall is now in center field. Crichton is now in left field. And Tristan Bassetta has checked into the game in right field. Ninth place hitter in the order, Dalton Pearson. Reached on a fielder's choice, one of two runners thrown out of the base pass by the starting catcher, Cooper Engel.
And that really was early on in the game when Georgia State had an opportunity to have possibly a couple of big innings. And Cooper Engel with two outstanding throws.
Allen challenging Pearson to get the count 3-2. Georgia State team, a potent lineup, limited just two runs on two hits so far. Hard shot to third. Eating up Starbuck, recovers, and he got him.
Wow. Really, really showed some arm strength there, some poise to pick it up barehanded. Did not have time to think about that throw. He just cut it loose, and it was right on target. And you're right, it kind of ate him up. Took a bit of a hop. See the bare hand, he was able to catch it on a bounce. Just got him by a quarter of a step.
Hammock the stretch at first. Really nice play by Max Starbuck. Contributed in the field and at the plate today. Top of the order, Cameron Jones. One for two. He singled and scored. Also reached on a walk. Right back to Allen. Another quick inning for Joe Allen. What good work he has done out of the bullpen. He's retired all nine batters that he's faced.
Hey, bud.
Wow. What's all this?
Hawaii was too expensive, so I brought it here.
You know, with Priceline, you could actually take that trip for less than all this.
I made a horrible mistake.
Yeah.
We made a horrible mistake.
Go to your happy price, Priceline.
Signs help us navigate our world. Signs keep us on course, headed in the right direction, excited about upcoming events, and punctuate important moments in our lives. Signs build brands, create connections, and define purpose. Signs speak with strength to communities, guests, clients, and customers. Signs create impact and grab attention like no other medium can. For over three decades with locations throughout the world, Signorama is the way to grow your business.
Kids are so expensive, Dad. Now Katie needs braces.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
I don't know, Dad.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
It's a great idea, TV Dad.
But I said the exact same thing.
Someday when you're a father, you'll understand.
I'm his father.
It's not a competition.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
There's your game summary. 10-12-1 for the Tigers. 2-2-1 for Georgia State. Landry in line for the loss. As of right now, Reed Garris get the win for Clemson. Did a nice job coming on a reliever. Then Joe Allen's been phenomenal as well. First home run of his Clemson career for Nathan Hall. First triple for Billy Amick. He's got a couple of hits today after that first career home run. And making just the second appearance in his career. He's pitched two innings so far, has allowed a hit. Perhaps a butterfly or two facing this Clemson team. So far, the only pitcher who they've used today that they used last night was McAllister. And after seeing him throw a number of pitches in the 66 to 70 mile an hour range, I can understand how he's probably able to go back-to-back days.
Well, right.
Hard liner off the bat of Amick for out number one in the Tigers' eighth inning.
That ball was hit hard right at someone. And again, that can be, you can be mired in a slump and you hit balls like that. And, you know, a guy that's got things going well can hit a 15 hopper up the middle for a base hit.
Yeah, it's like Cooper Engle earlier in the season.
Yeah.
That one right at Ruiz.
Yeah, great example.
Riley Bertram got the scoring going for the Tigers with a two-run single back in the third inning. Mm. Clemson then added three more on the Hall home run. Bertram 1-for-3 today. Fly out to center and a ground out to third as well. Ten RBIs after arriving from Michigan in the offseason.
Well, we've talked about the combination of Blackwell and Bertram up the middle and how solid they have been. A lot of experience between those two young men.
Stays low.
And I just mean in chronological years because they're both fifth-year seniors.
Douglas on a state championship team at Woodstock High in Georgia. Hard grounder on the right side, Donahoe to first. One second baseman retires the other, and it's out number two. Nathan Hall moved around the outfield today, has played in all three slots there. Delivered a big blow in this game, a three-run homer in the third inning. Also has a single, gets into that one, pretty well hit to left, but back on it and putting it away for the final out. Tigers retired here in the eighth inning, head to the ninth, 10-2.
You keep helping her with homework.
But we're only just now.
We'll help you save for her college.
Hi, I'm here for
your annual eye exam.
Exactly. I'm here because I'm having trouble
reading.
Exactly.
They sort of make me feel
like I'm the most fabulous thing you've ever seen. Like lightning is running up and down your spine.
Exactly.
I'll take them.
Join me for the least athletic event of the year, the Oscars.
Who will triumph when this year's greatest movies go head-to-head?
Thank you. It's the one that always goes to overtime.
The Oscars, live Sunday, March 12th on ABC.
I'm light as a feather, I'm light as a feather, yeah, baby, I flow. It's hard to look at my resume and not find a reason to toast. I'm counting my blessings, we ain't stressing, just look at this glow.
It's Saturday primetime, Bucks Warriors on ABC.
Boy, it is a battle royale over on the hill above left field. A little spring football action for them at Doug Kingsmore Stadium. As for the guys playing the game, Tigers ahead 10-2. Last chance for Georgia State. Joe Allen trying to close this game out. Jaden Anderson, pinch hitter, freshman out of Duluth, Georgia. Stands in for Ryerson, who in the ball game was 0-for-2 with a walk and a run scored.
Joe Allen has been simply outstanding to this point.
3-1, 9 up, 9 down.
Yeah. Tigers asking him to finish this one off and save that bullpen for the second game.
Lead off walk. So Anderson stands at first. Reaching for a fifth time this season on a base on balls. Matt Ruiz, the shortstop, homered last night.
Yeah.
So far 0-for-2 today with a walk. He was left stranded at third in the fourth inning. It looked like it was going to be a lot more for Georgia State than the two that they pushed across. In the air to right. And put away.
Bassetta out there now.
Bassetta out there in the outfield. Tigers have shifted around quite a bit as the day has continued, but Tristan Bassetta able to put it away for out number one.
It always finds you. If you're a substitute in a ball game, it'll find you.
Chopper to short. Blackwell on to first. They get Stewart to ground into a double play to close it out. And the Tigers take game one of this Saturday twin bill. And the second in as many games against Georgia State this weekend, 10-2. Stewart had checked into the game as a defense replacement. Wasn't up to bat all that long. Chad Ferry had just checked in at first as a defensive replacement, a 6-3 double play to close it out. Tigers, their 13th twin killing of the season. A ninth win on the year. Good effort by the bats. And frankly, after the starter, Tristan Smith, got into a little bit of trouble, the bullpen locked the door.
Well, two big innings for the Tigers, two five-run innings for the Tigers, and then an absolutely outstanding job done by this Clemson bullpen once again.
Join us about an hour for game number two. For Ron Smith, Pete Yannity, this has been a presentation of ESPN.
92% of households that kick off the year with Peloton are still active a year later.
Yeah, active.